Good morning, everyone. Welcome to worship this morning. I'm delighted to see you all, even the people I can't see.
Hi, everybody.
Just a few announcements to lift up before we really get started. First of all, we are pleased to have Stone Soup, a group from Northwood, here to lead us in worship. One announcement with that, all of the loose offerings that we collect this morning will go to Stone Soup to help with their expenses. So the loose offerings in the plate will go to Stone Soup. Last night, we did have a baptism. Michaela Joyce Ballack, the daughter of Michael and Cassie, she was baptized here last night. So please remember them in your prayers. A couple other prayer concerns that we'd like to share. Cora Miller, the granddaughter of Beth and Jim Olson, is in the hospital in Iowa City. So please keep Cora and that family in your prayers. And Doris Rage, Marianne Benteen's sister-in-law, is in the hospital in Rochester recovering from surgery. So please keep Doris in your prayers as well. And then we do thank Harley and Clarissa Johnson for this week's television broadcast, given in memory of J. Seal Gisselson. And then the last announcement that I have to lift up is there's a whole page in your announcements, and there's a table in the narthex all about Vacation Bible School. Coming up here on August 4th is when we'll begin that. So please take some look at that. Make sure that all of the kids under your watch are signed up. And there's also on the table out in the narthex is the poster board that has some needs for Vacation Bible School. So if you're willing and able, take one of those slips and then bring the items back. That's all the announcements that I have to lift up. Do you have any other announcements that we need to know? Nope? All right. Well then, in the name of Jesus Christ, let us worship.
Thank you.
Bernie Bendalis on harmonica, Jim Berg on the bass guitar, Denny Ryerson here on the sixth string, and I'm Ron Christensen on banjo. We have Esther Ryerson here on our computer, and my wife Linda on the sound system. You know, don't you just love a song that gets you hopping right away? We'd like your participation in this next one. Clap along. It's called A Good Old Gospel Song.
Thank you. I stand here. Good morning. Keeping track of all the things I did wrong so as to know whether I'd make it to heaven or hell when I die. He was out there sort of like a president. I recognized his picture when I saw it, but I really didn't know him. But later on, when I met Christ, it seemed as though life were rather like a bike ride. But it was a tandem bike. And I noticed that Christ was in the back helping me to pedal. I don't know just when it was that he suggested we change places, but life has never been the same since. When I had control, I knew the way. It was rather boring, but predictable. It was the shortest point between two points. But when he took the lead, he knew delightful long cuts up mountains and through rocky places at breakneck speeds. It was all I could do to hang on. Even though it looked like madness, he'd say, "Pedal." I was worried and was anxious and asked, "Where are you taking me?" He laughed and didn't answer, and I started to learn to trust. I forgot my boring life and entered into the adventure. And when I'd say, "I'm scared," he'd lean back and touch my hand. He took me to people with gifts that I needed, gifts of healing, acceptance, and joy. They gave me gifts to take on my journey, my Lord's and mine. And we were off again. He said, "Give the gifts away, they're extra baggage, too much weight." So I did, to the people that we met. And I found that in giving, I received, and still our burden was light. I did not trust him at first in control of my life. I thought he'd wreck it. But he knows bike secrets, knows how to make it bend and take sharp corners, knows how to jump to clear high rocks, knows how to fly to short and scary passages. And I'm learning to shut up and pedal in the strangest places. And I'm beginning to enjoy the view and the cool breeze on my face with my delightful, constant companion, Jesus Christ. And when I'm sure I just can't do anymore, he just smiles and says, "Pedal." Isn't that a delightful little story? It talks about a different journey, a different path to do Jesus' work. Each and every one of us has a different story, because everyone's journey, everyone's path, is different. My own adventure really started when I was asked if I wanted to become a lay speaker. My first thought was, just what would I have to say? And then who would want to listen to me? But that nudge to follow through was just too strong to ignore. And I really had no idea where that journey would take me. But I guess Jesus did have some plans for me. It was a few years later that I received a phone call and asked to join Stone Soup. When I started my journey with Jesus, I really had no idea that it would include giving a message to all the congregations where Stone Soup performs, or that I would be here with you today. But Jesus seemed to know just where I needed to go on that journey with him. Now Simon Peter and James and John must have been extraordinary people. They knew enough to give Jesus total control of their lives from the very beginning. For me, I've had to take little baby steps in the journey with Jesus, learning as I go. But as in the story, I'm beginning to enjoy the view and the cool breeze on my face. So now, I come to the part of my message where I need to include all of you. Just what does your journey with Jesus look like? Your journey could include helping to feed the 1 in 5 people that will go to bed hungry tonight. Or it could include helping to mentor a child that needs your guidance. Or it could include volunteering at the school to reach children. It could include any of thousands of things. I don't know what your journey looks like. But I do know that Jesus is calling you. There is still work to be done. And Jesus has a journey for you and a plan for each of you. Even though you may not know what lies ahead, I can tell you that if you answer this call, you will have an adventure that you cannot imagine. And sometimes, just like with me, it's as easy as picking up the phone when it rings and saying, "Yes, the story, you can learn to trust and to give and to just lean back and enjoy the ride. And when you're sure that you just can't do anymore, pedal. Please pray with me. Gracious God, we hear you calling. You have shown us hope and you offer us courage. We come to you as people who long to walk your pathways of grace and love. But many times, God, we get discouraged by our living. We are afraid of the difficult experiences. We despair of challenges that are given to us. The roads we walk find us weary sometimes. We let hopelessness get the best of us. Care for us on our journey, God. Help us to know that your love is always there, sustaining us and surrounding us with care. Take our road-weary lives and transform us to be your new people, shining in the darkness. Amen. And now as the group comes back up to join me, I'd like to tell you a little bit about this next song. I don't care how old your children get. My middle child is going to have a birthday this year, this next week, and he's going to be 41 years or 31 years old. That's not a thing. It doesn't matter how old they get, you still worry about your children. Okay? All your mothers, you know that. Well, this next song is an open phone call to Mama. It's called Hello Mama.
I pray so long. 6 to 7 inch rainfall, and it was to where water was going over the interstate. And you maybe you probably saw this news item on TV that night because it made national news. A vehicle lost control of it. There were two adults and a little 3-year-old girl in that vehicle. And so the Northside Fire Department got out on that call, and one of the firemen went to that vehicle and brought that little gal back to safety, to the fire trucks. And the water was deep enough in that median that for a second there, they went underwater, both the little gal and the fireman. But she was a real trooper, never complained a bit until she got back to the fire truck. And then she told the farmer, she says, "I don't like that brown water. It don't taste good. I like blue water." So this next song here is called Muddy Water.
Thank you. Oh. shows no interest, my child has gone so far. Though I try my best to reach them, their hearts just seem so hard. Lord, what can I do to help bring them back to you? For my family's lost and dying, and my words do not get.
Until the walls come down, till there's healing.
this last number that we're going to do today is titled On My Journey Home. And you know, all of us here on earth, it's a journey. Our life is a journey. And it's how we, what we do in that journey that counts. And I'd like to challenge you. The song starts out with a chorus. And I would want you to listen to that and challenge you to make that your goal for this week, every day.